Greetings everyone. In this video, I will show you how you can understand the effect of each prompt you are using to generate images by text to image. To see that, we will use DAAM extension of Stable Diffusion Automatic1111 Web UI. If you don't know yet what is Stable Diffusion Automatic1111 or how to use them, I have excellent tutorial series playlist on my channel. This is the playlist and you see we have so far 14 plus videos how to use Stable Diffusion for Automatic1111 and for how to use Stable Diffusion on Google Colab. So DAAM is the method name the authors of this paper have chosen, interpreting Stable Diffusion using cross-attention. The paper aims that how does an input word influence parts of the generated image. The authors of the paper has released their script to use it, and there is an extension for Automatic1111 that allow us to use this script. This is the extension repo link. Now I will install this extension on my Automatic1111. To do that, I am going to extensions tab and in here click install from URL, paste it and install. It has been installed. Let's just apply and restart UI. Extension has been installed. So how are we going to use it? You see there will be a new option here, attention heat map. This is where we are going to use this extension, and I am going to make my examples on Protegen X3.4 version. This is where you can download this model. It's a very good model, very realistic model. So let's start by typing our first prompt and see how each word is affecting our prompt. This is the prompt I have used, a sports car, beautiful oasis with palm trees, and you see we got a beautiful image right here. Before starting that, I want to show you that Python, this is the version I'm using, Torque version, Xformers version, Gradio, Commit Hash, and Checkpoint Hash, if you wonder that. So how are we going to get the heat map of this image? To do that, I am just copying this prompt here and going to the attention heat map, pasting it here, and you need to put comma for each word to see their emphasis on the picture. Also, pick this use grid output to grid directory. There is an easier way to put comma to each of the word. To do that, you can use notepad plus plus, and in the find what, just put a space character and replace with comma, replace all, and you will get the prompt separated with commas. Okay, I am also putting the seed as same seed like this, and then I will hit generate, and then we will see the each one of the prompt effect on the image. So you see there are now two images. One of them is showing the effect of each prompt and the output is here. When we click the heat map, we can see how much each word is affecting our result. For example, there is a little bit too much effect of a keyword and perhaps with keyword. So if you want to reduce the effect of some of the keywords, you can use this heat map and reduce them. For example, let's reduce the effect of a keyword like here and the with keyword like this one. This will reduce the strength, the effect of the both of the keywords. This is prompt emphasis of the Automatic1111 Web UI feature. Now we can see the effect of a and with keyword are decreased. And let's see the output image. Okay, it is like this. If you are still not satisfied with the image, then you can also increase the effect of other keywords and decrease some other ones. For example, if palm is having too much effect and beautiful or oasis is having little effect, we can also modify them. Let's reduce to 0.8. Let's also increase oasis to 1.2. And also let's increase beautiful to 1.2. And let's reduce car to 0.8. If you don't know how these attention emphasis is working, there is a wiki page on Automatic1111 and it is displaying how they are affecting the results. So this is how it is increasing attention. This is how decreasing attention. This is how it is working basically. Okay, so we got our new results. This is our new result and this is how each word is having effect. Car, oasis, beautiful, wheat, trees, palm, a. So based on the result, you can even further modify image and you can decide what to choose, what to decrease strength, what to increase emphasis. Also, there are some other options. Heat map blend alpha. If you make this one, then it won't show the original image in the generated heat map. So it will be like this. Then you will have a more clear idea of how much each word is having effect. The trees are not having much effect because I think it is already using the palm word. Therefore, we can just remove the palm from the prompt and let's see what we are going to get. Yeah, we have removed the palm instead of trees and now we don't have palm but only trees. And now this is how the effect is appearing. The sports, beautiful, oasis and car. This is the new output. let's take it back. So I will just remove the trees and generate again. And now this is our image back, and this is now with car, sports, oasis, beautiful palm, and there is no more trees, therefore it has zero effect. And let's remove the with keyword. By the way, the combination of these keywords are generating a chain of effect, therefore they may not be displaying very much emphasis here, but as a chain effect they could be affecting a lot. So this is our new image, and this is the output we got. Car, sports, oasis, beautiful, they are like this. This is a cool and neat thing that you can play with. Based on this, you can increase or decrease the emphasis, the attention of the each word, and try to get a better understanding of how prompts are affecting your results. It's a cool addition. Hopefully see you in another video, but before, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and if you support us on Patreon, I would appreciate that very much. Sorry about my voice, I am a little bit off sick currently. I got cold, I think. So you can subscribe, like, join, and support us on Patreon. Hopefully see you in another video.